Hello students, welcome to Whitewash tutorial. Today we are going to discuss a new chapter, that is triangles. In this chapter, first we will learn about basic things which already you are familiar with. Those things, those are meaning of triangles, type of triangles, congruent and similar figures, similarity of triangles, Thales theorem, converse of Thales theorem. Meaning of triangle. Triangle is a closed figure with three sides and three angles. Next concept, it is types of triangles. Here we can divide the triangles in two categories. One is by sides and the other one is by angles. In that, first triangle, that is equilateral triangle. In equilateral triangle, all three sides are equal and three angles also equal to each other. Next one is isosceles triangle. Here two sides are equal and opposite to those sides means angles also equal to each other. And third is scalene triangle. Here no sides equal and no angles equal. In next category, you can divide the triangles based on their angle. In acute triangle, all three angles are acute angles, means less than 90 degree. It may be equilateral, isosceles or scalene. The next triangle is obtuse triangle. In this triangle, any one angle will be obtuse angle, means more than 90 degree. Next triangle, that is right triangle, or else you can say right angle triangle. In this triangle, one angle will be right angle, means equal to 90 degree. This is very important triangle. In this chapter, you will get two theorems based on this triangle. For that, you should know the part of this triangle. Here we will get always one angle will be 90 degree and opposite to that 90 degree, the side we can say it as hypotenuse and the bottom side we can call it as base and the vertical side we can say it as height. Next concept is about congruent and similar figures. Congruent, already we learnt in 9th class, that is congruency. Congruent means figures which have the same shape and same size, or else we can say exactly equal to each other. In 10th class, you will get here similar figures or similarity of triangles. Similar figure means figures have the same shape but not necessarily the same size. You can say it looks like that but not exactly. So that's why you can say those figures as similar figures. By this concept, we can conclude here few statement. All congruent figures are similar, but the similar figures need not be congruent. All circles are similar but not congruent. All squares are similar but not congruent. All equilateral triangles are similar. If we take two polygons of the same number of sides are similar, it should obey the two conditions. First condition, their corresponding angles are equal, and second condition, their corresponding sides are in same ratio or in same proportional. In similarity of triangles, if we say two triangles are similar, then it should obey the condition. First condition, their corresponding angles are equal. Here angle A equal to angle B, angle B equal to angle Q, and angle C equal to angle R. Second condition, their corresponding sides are in the same ratio or proportion. It means AB by PQ equal to BC by QR equal to AC by PR. Then we can say triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR. Theorem number 1, Thales theorem, or we can say it as basic proportionality theorem, BPT also. Statement: if a line is drawn parallel to one side of a triangle to intersect the other two sides in distinct points, the other two sides are divided in the same ratio. In given figure, DE is parallel to BC, so we have to show that AD by DB is equal to AE by EC. Let's start with given point in triangle ABC, where they given DE parallel to BC. To prove AD by DB equal to AE by EC, we need to construct here. In construction, first we have to draw the altitudes, so that will be DM perpendicular to AC and EN perpendicular to AB, and also join BE and CD. By drawing the perpendiculars, here we can get the ratio of the areas of those triangles. In proof, we have to take here ratio of areas of triangle ADE and area of triangle BDE, both having the same height or altitude, you can say it as EN. Using area of triangle formula, half into base into height. So here base is in triangle ADE, base is AD and height is EN. Similarly in triangle BDE, base is DB and height is EN. By cancelling the same terms, half and half will get cancelled and EN will get cancelled, after remaining AD by DB. So take it as equation number 1. Similarly on the right side, taking the ratio of area of triangle ADE and area of triangle CDE, same here also using the half into base into height formula. Half into, here in ADE we will get the base as AE and height as DM. Similarly in triangle CDE, half into base that is EC and height is same, that is DM. Again here also cancelling the same terms, we will get here ratio area of triangle ADE divided by area of triangle CDE is equal to AE by EC. So take it as equation number 2. We studied in 9th class that if two triangles on the same base and lie between the same parallel lines, then they having the equal area. Similarly here also triangle BDE and triangle CDE on same base, that is DE, and lie between the same parallel lines, then their area of triangles are equal. So area of BDE equal to area of CDE, that is equation number 3. From equation number 1, 2, 3, so we will get here AD by DB equal to AE by EC. Hence our theorem proved. Next theorem, it is converse of BPT. If a line divides any two sides of a triangle in the same ratio, then the line is parallel to the third side. Here only I'll end up this video. In next video, I'll solve second exercise. For more videos, subscribe our channel. For notification, press bell icon. Thank you.